Okay everyone, so this is the fourth part of this tropical landscape with elephant painting tutorial. And on this part I am going to put some details on this side. I'm going to put some banana tree or some trees or whatever that comes to my mind, and I'm going to put some highlights and shadings on the water. So this is gonna be really exciting on this part. So this might be the last part, and if you are painting with me, just follow what I'm doing and just have fun while you are painting, okay? So I think I'm gonna start now. So first I'll be using this number 8 nylon flat brush, hard handle. And if you want to know the materials that I'm using, especially the brushes and the paints, the colors, you need to refer or watch the first part of the part 1 of this painting tutorial. So here I'm going to add some light first on this water here, this part of the river. So I'm gonna use the blue and the white to make some light blue, and with a little I think purple. So I'm gonna add red to make it purple, light purple. I'm gonna add white to make it light purple. So here I'm gonna add some white there, white lines of the water. Okay, so it should be straight. I'm sorry. Okay, that's nice. And I'll be mixing some more blue and red to make some purple, and another white. So I'm going to paint the. I'm going to make it a little bluish, more bluish. And I'm going to paint the purple color of the reflection. There. I can also put some green color, so I'm gonna add some green, yellow to make some green and white, and let's add some highlight here. Make sure it's green, so I'm gonna add some more white. So just create a horizontal, a vertical strokes for the reflection. Just copy the reflection you see above the water. There. Okay, I think that's okay. And I think I'm gonna put some more dark here for the water reflection. I'm gonna use some blue and yellow with some a little amount of red with more blue here. There, And I'm gonna add some yellow, more yellow and white to create some reflection here. So reflection of the leaves should be lighter greens, and also here. You can just add a little amount of greens here. Okay. That's it. Don't put too much on it. Don't overdo it. I think that's enough. And I think I'm going to add highlights here on this part. I'm going to put some rocks or whatever, soils or grasses. Forgot to put some water. So I'll be using some raw umber with blue color. And let's add some few rocks here. And I'm going to use again this color with some white, yellow, and red. So let's add some rocks. Few rocks here. Do not overdo it, and you should leave some empty spaces to create depths. Here you can put some highlights using this color. It's a lighter brown color with a mixture of yellow, red, and blue. No blue guys, white's white, sorry. There, let's add some white highlights to create some highlights on the rocks there. I think it's just very easy to put the highlights. Again, do not overdo it, always remember that. There, so see, we have now some few rocks. But I need to put some trees here on the back. This part, and also some. I also want to put a banana tree. Yes. So I think I'm gonna put first the huge tree before the banana tree. So I'll be using this raw amber, and it's gonna put a very huge tree here. There. So I think I'm gonna put some smaller branches, and I'll be using a smaller brush, which is the number 7. That's it. And I'm going to add some blue to add some dark tones. There. And on each side, I'm going to put a banana tree here. Okay. So I'll be using first the bigger brush. This is the number 8 flat brush here. And let's see, make some green color, blue, yellow, and red to make it dark. Darker green. So I think I'm gonna put the banana tree here. And let us add some leaves. There. Another leaves here. More leaves. So we're gonna paint first the stalk, oh no, the branch. And it's gonna put some leaves there. There. Okay. We need more. So gonna put more leaves there. Okay. Okay, how about that? So we need to let it dry first a little, and let's proceed here on this part. I'm going to put some more dark tones there, so I'm gonna use the blue, the raw umber, and yellow there. So let's make this part darker. going to add, I'm going to make this part looks like shallow part of the river, and I'm going to put more some rocks underwater. So here I'm going to make some rocks red, yellow with blue color. Make sure it's a little bluish. Let's put more rocks there. It should be dark in color. So we need to mix it with a darker brown. Hit a little blue in it. Yeah, so we need to make this part brownish to make it look like shallow. We need to reveal the rocks, soils on this part here. And all you have to do is just glaze it. Place it. Okay. Okay, so let's add more highlights. So I'll be using this yellow and some red to make some orange and white. I'm using a smaller brush now because I'm going to put details, smaller details, small rocks. Let's add more yellow and red. to do it one by one. Okay, to do it one by one. Need to, but always remember not to overdo it. Leave some more dark space. Do not cover everything. Here, I'm gonna put. Okay. I'm gonna use a pure white. Okay. So I'm going to mix a little greenish here. Just mix the green in the raw amber, and let's retouch here. I think I'll add more white, make it lighter. There, make it darker. The more details you add, the better it will become. Okay. So we need to do it one by one. And here on the water, I'm going to add some rocks underwater, and I'm going to use more yellow and red and white and red again. So it should be darker. I'm going to add more. I'm gonna make it a little darker. I'm gonna add some blue color on it. There, that's good color. I must also to put some huge rocks underneath. That's pretty nice. And also, we're gonna put here. That's it. And I'm going to use the liner brush here, and I'm going to add some white lines on the water. So I'll be using some more white and mix it with a little blue. To put the ending of the water there. I'm not sure, I'm not really sure if it's visible on the distance. Okay. So we need to add more rocks here, but it should be dark. Now I'll be using darker color. Using bigger brush. So here, I'm gonna put more rocks. Here. And I'm going to add some white. A little highlights here. But I think I'm going to do it later when this one dries. Okay, and I'll be using a smaller brush. This is the number 7 flat brush. I'm going to add more white. I'm going to put a little highlights on these rocks here. But this is not from the sun, guys. Make sure that the color is not too much. It should not be lighter than this, the highlights here. There. Okay. Okay, so here I'm going to put some plants here. So let us figure leaves, something like that. So I'll be using some blue here and some white. So I'm using again the number 7 flat brush. There. I'm going to add some more blue. It doesn't have to be accurate, just make it look like an abstract. These are actually some herbaceous plants. I'm not really sure what you're gonna call it. Okay. And I'm going to put some darker colors. So I'm going to use this raw umber with blue. Just add some shades here. What's up, blue? And I'm going to add some more, some white to create highlights. Also other leaves. Okay, that looks nice. And later we're gonna add some highlights. And now it's time to put some highlights on the on this banana tree. So I think I'm going to use more yellowish highlights first. So I'm gonna add a little blue, make it yellow, green and white. There, it should be a yellow green color. So here, there. And I'm going to use some bluish stone here. I'm going to use some blue and white. It should be a little blue green color. We're going to put it on the darker side of the leaves. also here. I think it should be a little darker. Here. Just make it look like an abstract. It doesn't matter if it's perfectly shaped as leaves. We are creating here more on optical illusion. And I'll be using more white here. I'm going to make it as the highlights. Here. It looks nice. And then I'm going to use some yellow green color. And I'm going to put it here. Leaves will become transparent if there's light on the back. Okay. Anyway, that looks like realistic now. Okay, I'm going to put some brown leaves, and I'm gonna mix red and yellow. Mix some orange. Here. That's it. And also on the body of the, but I'm gonna make it a little darker, red and yellow. On the body of the what's it called, this banana tree. Some raw umber. I'm gonna put more raw umber, dark. That's really nice. Nice, and I'm gonna put more highlights. I'm gonna put some brown highlights here with some yellow. Okay, so for me that looks realistic, and here I'm gonna put more lights here. I think I'm gonna refill yellow on my palette. So here I'm gonna use more yellow and white, because I'm gonna put some more grasses here. So you just create an upward strokes. And also this part here, we're gonna put a little highlights on these plants. And one more yellow. And some white. I need to put some pure white here to make it brighter. And again, do not overdo it. Okay. Then I'm going to make some yellow green. I'm going to add some blue to make it yellow green and white. So I'm gonna add some highlights here. There, do not overdo it, guys. Just leave some more spaces, gaps. So I'm gonna add more yellow green. There. Okay. That looks nice. And now let's add some highlights on this tree. So I'll be using the raw umber with white. Lots of white, and it's gonna put it here. Yeah. And of course, we're gonna put some details on the other side. So I'm gonna use some blue and blue umber with white. Here. Okay. So I'm not really sure what I'm going to add. I think I'm going to add one tree here, one plant here, another plant here. Yeah. But first, I need to use some white and add some highlights here. Okay. So I'm going to move down a little because I'm going to add a little some plants here. Okay, using the number 7 pot brush. Let's mix some green, blue, and yellow with a little red. And I'm going to put it here. I'm going to do the stalk first. And let's create the leaves. So make it pointed. Okay. And I think I'm going to add another one here. But I'm gonna add some white. Okay, and next we're gonna put the highlights. So I'm gonna use more yellow and white. Got another highlight here. Okay. So I'm not sure what I'm going to add next, but I think I am contented. Yes, I think I'm contented with this one. And I think I consider it done. Maybe I'm just going to add more highlights here. I think it's not too light. I think I'm gonna add lighter colors on that part. So I'm gonna use more yellow. So it's not, I'm now retouching, guys. Yellow and red to make that, and need to add some white to make it lighter. Lighter. There. And here. Okay. And going to add some reflection. So you can use your fingers. Can create the reflection by a short strokes downward. There. And also this one here. So I think I am done, everyone. So I am contented with the result, and I think that will be fine, okay for me. So I hope you get something out of this and you learn something out of this tutorial, and you can apply it on your own, you can paint on your own, you can have your own landscape. Okay, so I want to say thank you guys for watching this video. Please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future, and if you are painting, just follow what I'm doing and just have fun painting. Okay, thank you guys, have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor always belongs to the Lord.